Have you ever heard about Chanakya? Who he was? What is his contribution? Under which leader he was working as a consultant? कुछ तो सुना होगा, कुछ तो बताइए. Anything you have heard?
चाणक्य सर की जो thoughts थे वो बहुत ही अच्छे आज भी implement होते हैं in management language.
What was it about? क्या था उनका specialty? Which things he has taught?
एक जो चीज उनको पता भी नहीं, मतलब उनको मतलब किसी ने एक्सपेक्ट भी नहीं किया था कि इन फ्यूचर हमें इन सब चीज की जरूरत पड़ेगी. उन्होंने वो चीज एज्यूम पहले ही कर लिया था कि इन फ्यूचर इन सब लॉ की उनको जरूरत पड़ेगी, मतलब आने वाली पीढ़ियों को. तो उन्होंने वो लॉस पहले ही अपने बुक में मेंशन किए थे.
ओके ओके. एंड लाइक हु वाज ही, व्हाट इज हिज बैकग्राउंड? वाज ही अ किंग और वाज ही अ Rishi or was he a spiritual leader? What do we know about? Anyone of you don't know about Chanakya, right? What is this? I like absolutely whatever he has told was a good thing, but what is that thing he was telling? What are the specialties? What are the areas of your life which has been highlighted by him? I said to me, he has highlighted everything of your life, including like science, technology, and all things, right? He had certain specialties, certain areas of your knowledge to be improved. In that, क्या किया था उन्होंने? बता लो, दो क्लास में आया था तो किसने तो सुना होगा चाणक्य को ने? और क्या करते थे? क्या तो?
He was a good leader.
Okay. Actually, Chanakya himself was not a leader, right? He was a consultant. He was the spiritual guru of king, right? Which king he was? Was he king guru? No idea. It was a little bit stronger, guys. Who was the Chanakya? चाणक्य किस राजा के गुरु थे? चाणक्य कौन से राज्य में रहते थे? चाणक्य क्या क्या किया? चाणक्य का जो भी कंट्रीब्यूशन हो, इज देयर एनीथिंग एल्स दैट चाणक्य इज नोन फॉर, और इज देयर एनी अदर नेम बाय चाणक्य वाज नोन, राइट? ये सब चीजें आप लोगों को पता होनी चाहिए. नॉट दैट इफ आई डोंट एक्सपेक्ट दैट यू नो एवरीथिंग अबाउट द चाणक्य, बट चाणक्य नीति और चाणक्य नीति और द फिलोसॉफी गिवन बाय चाणक्य और व्हाट इज लाइक द पर्सन द कौटिल्य, चाणक्य इज आल्सो एज द कौटिल्य, लाइक So Kautilya's Arthashastra is something which is very much well known about the Chanakya. Chanakya's contribution in the economy, he was known as the great economist, right? And he was a philosopher also, an economist and teacher also. Yes, sorry, you want to say something?
Sir, aapki voice bahut break hoke aa rahi hai.
Voice break, aur wo ho jayega, theek, wo chodo, uska kya hai, tab chalta hai wo, aage piche hoke neat aa jayega, right? Whatever I am asking you guys, like nobody wants to contribute, what is something we discuss. And why I am asking you guys? See, I can decide what are the things I need to focus based on the inputs that you are giving. If you could have given me bit information about the background of Kautilya, that is, he was also known as the Chanakya, he was also known as the Vishnupta, right? And he lived in the 4th century before Christ, that is, his philosophy was very much well known and applicable till the 20th century also, right? So, he has written some books called as Chanakya Niti, Chanakya's Arthashastra. He was a very visionary political strategician, right? Very visionary political strategician, and he was under the king. He was a consultant of the king Chandragupta Maurya, right? And you all know how he has. See, now I cannot tell you all the stories about all his success. And I will only tell you background. And if you are interested to know, just go to the YouTube and you will get to know that so many research done for the Chanakya, right? Chanakya's philosophy was not that, or Kautilya's Arthashastra, like Kautilya's Arthashastra was not that famous till very recent times, till very recent times, right? So in the era of 19th century, somewhere in 1960s, this book has got published on this Chanakya's Niti by a Tamilian professor, South Indian professor, and he has published that book. And then his laws of economy, then his laws of political science, then his contribution in terms of political strategies and warfare strategies has been become very much famous, right? So when you know that the Chanakya was working as a consultant to king, right? He was the consultant to the king. He was guru of the king. He was Brahmin by birth, and he has consulted Chandragupta Maurya, the king who has lost his everything. Then they have made up the strategies with very few people, and they have then used some warfare tactics by which they have won entire Asian region, right? Not only India, they have won entire Asian region and some part of the China for that matter also. So the Asian region, the countries in which they were ruling, that story, that warfare, how it happened, how it was, we don't need to discuss it. The point is that the very well-known Kautilya has written a book on what are the principles that a king has to consider. What are the principles that king has to consider while he is thinking to develop and establish the economy of his own dynasty, economy of his own country, right? So he kind of along, see, book is known as a Kautilya Arthashastra. The book is known as Kautilya Arthashastra, but it has a very wider scope, right? Its scope bahut jyada wider hai. It also talks about the behavior that king has to have. What are the ways, what are the patterns of the behavior that king has to follow? So he has given guidelines for a king, and those guidelines are actually given to the Chandragupta Maurya, but these were applicable for so many other things also. And these guidelines are applicable to the great politicians also, if they take it in a positive spirit. And if they do those things together, they will definitely create an impact on the Indian society, right? So this Vishnugupta, or the Kautilya, or the Chanakya, right? These three people are, like, these three names are for the one person only. So never get confused if someone says that what is Kautilya Arthashastra. This Kautilya Arthashastra is itself known as the Chanakya Niti, right? It's itself known as the Chanakya Niti. And his name was Vishnugupta. This Kautilya and Chanakya, these were the names given by Chandragupta Maurya to his guru, right? So the Chanakya is a symbol of excellence. He was a prime minister. He was the main minister, one of the head of ministerial people of Chandragupta Maurya. And this Chandragupta Maurya has established his empire under his guidance, the entire Chandragupta dynasty. It is very famous in history. I don't know if people have learned, understood, and remember about the dynasty, Maurya dynasty. That must have been part of your history and sociology in terms of the modern history of India, right? So this empire, Maurya empire, also got established under the strategies of Chanakya and Chandragupta Maurya. So, and as we know that the book, this Maurya, Chandragupta Maurya, has been guided by the book called as Kautilya Arthashastra, right? And there are a few mantras which have been given in Kautilya Arthashastra. And those mantras are nothing but the strategies or the rules or the things which Chanakya had asked Chandragupta Maurya to take care. If he stick to the suggestions given by Chandragupta Maurya, then the success is ensured for that king. It has become a formula those days. Whatever the Chanakya suggested, whatever Chanakya did for the Maurya dynasty came into reality. So strategically, actually, if Chandragupta Maurya and Chanakya wanted to win entire planet, like strategically win kar sakte the. They have had that kind of huge power. But you all know that Indian people are the people, those who are having limited, like, they are human beings first. Chandragupta Maurya was king, and this Kautilya Chanakya was his consultant. Itna dono ne hangama macha ke rakha tha duniya mein ki puri duniya jeet sakte the. Like, we had Britishers won entire world, and ये लोग जीत सकते थे पूरी दुनिया को, बट इनका चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य का प्रॉब्लम था कि ही वाज अगेंस्ट दी हिंसा, जो मारे जाते हैं ना युद्ध के वॉर में, जो मारे जाते हैं, लाइक जब युद्ध होता है तो लोग मर पड़ते हैं, सो ही नेवर फेवर दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग. ही वाज अ गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग. तो स्पिरिचुअल लोग हैं, इंडियन पीपल आर हाईली स्पिरिचुअल पीपल सिंस एंशिएंट टाइम्स. सो दे थॉट दैट वी नीड नॉट टू बी एंटायर वर्ल्ड, व्हाटएवर वी हैव वन, एंड वी जस्ट वांटेड टू प्रिजर्व इंडिया एंड एशियन रीजन अंडर आवर कंट्रोल. सो इन सबने वो इंडिया और एशियन रीजन को जीत लिया था. And very few part of Sri Lanka and some other Asian region was not under the Maurya for few days, but they have won most of the Asian region. So वो बोलते थे हिंसा करके पूरी दुनिया के राज करने में कोई मतलब नहीं. We will go and make our own country better, make our own people living better. So they were not interested. So they stopped expanding their kingdom, and they have settled it up to the Asian region. And then Chanakya has started working on the betterment of his own kingdom. On the economy, on the political relations, diplomatic relations with the adjacent people, adjacent dynasties, in some cases, they came to Ashoka Gupta Chanakya, right? So, if you can share the screen, the screen is visible. Visible, hai? Nahi, share kiya na. So, ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं है. Chanakya की कोई पढ़ने वाले हम लोग, and I keep telling you all those things. You just note down the time, some few interesting points which Chanakya has told. Chanakya has told his king. So Chanakya was saying that the first principle given by the Chanakya to his king was your people comes first, right? Chanakya Niti, first strategy of Chanakya for getting your kingdom in the right direction, or getting your dynasty in proper way, or keeping your people in the favor of king. That is the most important thing, right? What whenever you talk about the kingdom and his strategies, agar praja hai to raja hai, agar praja raja ko raja manti hai, praja raja ko support karti hai, to raja ka astitva hai. Then the existence of king came into picture, right? If people do not support the king not be king for longer time. People will protest again the king, and that he can be destroyed, right? So Chanakya was talking to his king, or suggesting to his king to keep his people first, right? So the first point that Chanakya told is your people come first. And what is this particular point talking about, right? It is like every king has to ensure that the people in your dynasty doesn't get the poverty, right? They should not get into poverty. People should not be treated with injustice. People should be provided all the basic amenities. Right? So the Chanakya is the one who has suggested the importance of irrigation first of all. Irrigation, you know, the water and ancient क्या बोलते हो उसको, इरिगेशन को क्या बोलते हो, खेती को पानी देने की जो सुविधा होती है सिस्टम्स लाइक डैम्स लाइक कैनल्स लाइक बड़े बड़े तालाब बनाना उसकी नई खेती तक लेके जाना, दैट इज द सिस्टम दैट वी सजेस्टेड फर्स्ट टाइम बाय चाणक्य टू द चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य इन इंडिया राइट. सो ही वाज आस्किंग हिज स्कीम टू बी इन फेवर ऑफ पीपल, ही वाज सजेस्टेड, ही हैज सजेस्टेड स्कीम टू गिव द फर्स्ट इंपोर्टेंस टू द पीपल इन टर्म्स ऑफ जस्टिस, इन टर्म्स ऑफ सेफ्टी, इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन एंड ऑल दिस थिंग राइट. सो what people need, like he has also given high importance to the Gokulam system those days, right? So this Chandragupta Maurya and Chanakya, both of them have come up with the Takshashila University, right? So the Takshashila University, and for the education of the people, and few of the irrigation projects, and safety to the people in the country, and injustice, awareness of injustice to the people, like proper law and regulation system has been established by Chanakya and Chandragupta Maurya. So the first lesson that Chanakya has given to the king is about your people comes first. When you talk about people comes first, isn't it 100% applicable to the business? Samajh aa raha hai kya bol raha hu? Are getting my point? Arjit, Saurik, Deepti, am I clear to all? Do you know what we are discussing? Hello, am I audible to all? Are getting my point? So Chanakya was one. Nobody there. How inhuman you people could be like? Why don't you respond? I don't. It is like if someone is talking to you and you are getting quiet. How you can solve it? Am I audible to you all?
Yes, sir.
So fine. I will do my job. I don't worry about this. All those things. So the point is that your people comes first. It's suggested by Chanakya to the Chandragupta Maurya, and 100% applicable in today's business also. Like every manager, every marketer, every person who.
Actually, sir. सर आपकी वॉइस बहुत ब्रेक हो गया, इसलिए कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा अभी आप क्या बोल रहे हैं.
फाइन कोई बात नहीं, जितना समझ सकते हो समझो. यहाँ पे आप लोग अगर आधा घंटे बड़बड़ करने के बाद, मैं जब आधा घंटा बोल लेता हूँ उसके बाद अगर आप मुझे बोलते हो कि मैं जो बोल रहा हूँ वो समझा नहीं है, बीच में आपको कोई अपॉर्चुनिटी नहीं, यू हैड नो चांस ऑफ रेजिंग योर हैंड और सेइंग समथिंग, व्हाट कैन आई बी, आई डिड मिस द पॉइंट राइट.
सर मैंने स्टार्टिंग में बोला था तो आपने कहा था वो सही हो जाएगा.
तो अभी कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है सुनने में? No, sir,
अभी तो
क्लियर है. चलो, so the point of discussion was that Chanakya was suggesting to his king that the happiness of king lies in the happiness of his people, right? So in the happiness of subjects lies the happiness of the king, is the statement made by Chanakya. In their welfare, his welfare. Take that statement, I read for you, just try to understand. अगर समझ में आ रहा है तो. Chanakya has written his book. And the lines are quoted like, in the happiness of his subject lies the king's happiness. In their welfare, his welfare. He shall not consider as good only that which please him, but it as beneficial to him whenever please his subject. Right? जब कोई आपको अच्छा बोलता है, तो आप खुद को अच्छा नहीं लगना चाहिए. Whenever people will say good about you, do not consider that this is truth. Whenever people say good about your people, then you can consider that this is the real appreciation. आपके राज्य को अच्छा बोला जाता है, आपके राज्य की प्रजा को अच्छा बोला जाता है, आपके राज्य में जो लोग रहते हैं उनको अच्छा बोला जाता है. सो दैट इज द रियल प्रेज. अगर किंग को अच्छा बोला जाता है इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि वो किंग बहुत बड़ा है. फॉर एग्जांपल इंडिया के लोगों को अच्छा बोला जाता है, इंडिया के लोगों का लाइफ स्टाइल अच्छा हो जाता है, अगर इंडिया के लोगों का इनकम बढ़ जाता है, अगर इंडिया के लोगों को दुनिया में प्रेज करने लगते हैं लोग, देन इज द सक्सेस ऑफ द प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड द रूलिंग पार्टी. सिर्फ मोदी जी अच्छा अच्छा बोल बोले कहीं इंडिया का भला होने वाला नहीं. सो व्हेनेवर पीपल यू हैव टू एप्रिशिएट और यू हैव टू कंसीडर द एप्रिशिएशन गिवन टू द पीपल ओनली, पीपल ऑफ योर किंगडम ओनली. And there you can understand whether it is really been developing or not. So the if you want to measure your success, if you want to understand the lifestyle of your king and working style of your king, then you have to understand the lifestyle of your people. And log acche reh rahe hai to raja acha hai, iska matlab ye hai. Similarly, it is applicable in your business also. If your customers are getting 100% benefits from your product, right? If your customers are getting benefited by your product, then your product is good in the market. It's not by only branding you can say that my product is very good in the market, right? So the application, this is the first law of that your people comes first is highly applicable in the business. You have to give the first importance to your people, to your customers, to your employees, to your stakeholders for that matter, right? It is always said that customers are king. The second point that Kautilya or this Chanakya or the person named as Vishnugupta said that people in power must be accessible, right? What you need to focus every time is people in power must be accessible. Jo log power mein accessible honi chahiye, they should be available for the people, for the common people of your country. So king, the Chanakya suggested to king that all your ministers should be accessible to the people. Sabko access hona chahiye, right? So the statement in his book written and quoted as, when in the court he shall never cause his petitioners to wait at door. When king is in the court, he shall never cause his petitioner to wait in the door. मतलब अगर आप किसी को न्याय देना चाहते हो तो आपके पास कोई अगर कोई कंप्लेंट लेके आता है तो उस कंप्लेंट को रिजोल्व करने के लिए जो आने वाला है उससे पहले राजा कोर्ट में होना चाहिए, राइट? मतलब क्या है, पीपल आर कंप्लेनिंग टू यू, यू शुड बी हाईली एक्सेसिबल, लाइक पीपल आर राइटिंग यू ईमेल एंड यू आर हैविंग देयर इश्यूज इन योर बिजनेस, बीइंग अ मार्केटिंग मैनेजर और बीइंग अ कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजर, इट इज वेरी वेरी सैड सिचुएशन दैट यू कैन क्रिएट फॉर योर बिजनेस एंड फॉर योर एग्जिस्टेंस इन द मार्केट फॉर दैट मैटर, राइट? सो इट इज सेड बाय कौटिल्य दैट व्हेन इन द कोर्ट, मतलब व्हेन ही इज इन द कोर्ट, ही शैल नेवर कॉज हिज पिटिशनर टू वेट एट द डोर. Customers should never be waiting to you. Customers should never be waiting to you for getting their queries resolved, right? So your people, your managers, or your stakeholders for that matter should not be waiting to get resolved about their questions and queries, right? So you have to address it and you have to be available for the people. So for the next statement made by the Kautilya was, for when a king makes himself inaccessible to his people and entrusts his work to his immediate officers, he may be sure to engender confusion in business and cause thereby public disaffection and himself prey to his enemies. For example, it is saying that अगर राजा अपना काम किसी और को दे देता है, किसी और को दे देता है और वो बंदा उसका काम अच्छे तरीके से नहीं करता है, तो this particular thing will lead to creating the enemies for the king in his people, right? So अपना काम खुद राजा को करना चाहिए, justice has to be given by the king himself, right? So you all know that king is very much surrounded by his people and by his ministers always, right? So king should not consider that the person who is coming to him for getting justice should be same to someone else and some other people for getting the thing done. So likewise, the business leaders at the top of the business hierarchy are often not accessible. Most of the time, they are not being accessible to the bottom people, right? And their common complaints in daily life do not get resolved by the people in the business hierarchy. So what happens, right? So they listen to the person who is sitting up to the middle level, like someone in the manager level, and they create mess in the business. So you have to ensure that you will be accessible to people and you are providing them, you will be providing them the proper information from your end itself. So the top people should be always accessible for the customers, people, employees, and all the stakeholders. Then hold people accountable for their work, right? Hold people accountable for their work. King has to ensure that he is holding people accountable for their work. If you do not ensure the proper accountability and responsibility of your people, they will be behaving according to their own understanding, their own nature, their own strategies, and this will create issue for the people, right? So king is suggested to impose the punishments, right? The punishments to the people, those who are not treating the people with respect, treating the people of your dynasty with respect. अगर आपके मिनिस्टर आप लोगों के साथ बदतमीजी करते हैं, अगर बाइबल भी देखी ना आपने, वो सेना को टच करता है तो उसके पूरे चार उंगलियां काट देता है, वो बोलते हैं उंगलियां काटने से कुछ नहीं होता, गला काटना चाहिए, समथिंग लाइक दैट. इफ यू डू नॉट सी इट्स अकाउंटेबिलिटी एंड इट्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ दैट सेनापति नॉट टू रिस्पेक्ट ऑल पीपल एंड नॉट टू बी इनह्यूमन विद एनीवन, राइट? सो ही हैज क्रॉस दैट लिमिट एंड द हलालदेवा वाज नॉट टेकिंग द राइट एक्शन, सो ही हैज नॉट डन द ड्यूटीज ऑफ द किंग. द किंग ड्यूटीज ऑफ द किंग आर नथिंग बट ही हैज टू पनिश. Duties of the king are nothing but he has to punish the person who is not completing his responsibilities, and he should be able to decide the accountability. And if someone is not completing the duty, he should be punished. That's what the recommendation given by Chanakya to the Chandragupta Maurya. And similar ways in the business is also it is applicable, right? So the business leaders must be understanding about the performance and accountability of their employees. Like they should avoid overburdening the people, but at the same time they should ensure that the person who is given the particular targets according to his abilities should be achieved by anyhow. If someone do not achieve it, then managers should not just let go the thing, right? Then managers should not just let go the thing, and they have to take the corrective action, and they have to punish those individuals in the business also. So the punishment is equally required and important in order to maintain your performance and your behavior, right? So these are the few guidelines that Chanakya was talking to the Chandragupta Maurya about his dynasty. And that is applicable to the businesses also, right? So agar aapke business mein koi unethical kaam karta hai, koi corruption karta hai, to aap usko chhodne khade wale ho, and chhodne nahi chahiye, right? If you punish that person once, then this can be very much possible that the similar mistake could be repeated multiple times. So accountability, punishment, these are the things that every business manager has to keep in mind, and you can just treat your people accordingly, right? Another point, the king has not to take the decisions, right? King has not to take the decisions. And he has to do the right things at the right time, right? He has to do the right things at the right time. And the statement written by Chanakya in his book, I just read it, it's in a quotation mark. All urgent calls he shall hear at once, but never put off for when postponed, right? King has to hear all urgent calls at once, but never put off or when postponed, they will prove too hard, impossible to accomplish, right? So अगर आपके पास कोई complaint आता है, अगर आपके पास कोई information आती है, अगर आपके पास कोई input आता है, तो king has to hear it and even if you are so much busy and you have so many other tasks to do, you have to hear those urgent calls at once. अगर हो नहीं सकता है जो भी हो प्रॉब्लम हो आप सबको वो प्रॉब्लम है एटलीस्ट सुनो और सुनने के बाद आप प्रायोरिटी कर सकते हैं कौन से चीज पे क्या काम करना चाहिए. देयर इज वन काइंड ऑफ सजेशन गिवन बाय द चाणक्य एंड इफ यू डिले टू हियर इफ यू डिले पोस्टपोन टू हियर द इंफॉर्मेशन और द इनपुट्स प्रोवाइडेड बाय योर पीपल देन स्लोली स्लोली एज टाइम पासेस इट विल बिकम वेरी हार्ड एंड इट विल बिकम ऑलमोस्ट इम्पॉसिबल फॉर द किंग और द मैनेजर टू अकम्प्लिश द टास्क व्हिच हैज बीन सजेस्टेड बाय योर पीपल राइट व्हिच हैज बीन रिकमेंडेड बाय योर पीपल. अगर कोई राज्य के पास कोई उसका जो गुप्त का गुप्तहर होता है जो जो सीक्रेट इन्फॉर्मेशन लेके देता है राइट उसको उसको अगर राजा 25 काम में बिजी है और कोई इन्फॉर्मेशन लेके आया राजा उसको सुना ही नहीं और इवनिंग में जाके सुना तो क्या प्रॉब्लम होगा. फ्री होने के बाद सुना तो क्या होगा. फ्री होने के बाद सुन लिया तब तो इन्फॉर्मेशन जो स्ट्रैटेजी बनानी थी वो बनाने में बहुत लेट हो जाएगा राइट. सो सिमिलरली इन द बिजनेस लीडर्स दे शुड नो द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ टाइम मैनेजमेंट एंड दे शुड ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू शेड इट फॉर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू डिले द डिसीजन मेकिंग राइट. सो डिले डिसीजन मेकिंग कैन टेक यू टू अ वेरी negative performance, right? It can take you, it can slow down your growth, it can slow down your performance in the market. So when you do not solve multiple problems at a time, right? So then what happens? Those multiple problems shows the snowball effect. You know snowball effect? It means they accumulate other problems. एक के वजह से दूसरा failure, दूसरे के वजह से तीसरा failure. Life में होता है ना, बहुत बार हम कुछ mistakes कर जाते हैं, बहुत बार financial चीजों के वजह से हम cost हो जाते हैं, overcome हो जाते हैं, किसी और से पैसा लो, इसका पैसा लेके उसको दो, उसका पैसा लेके और किसी को दो. ये सब करने के चक्कर में हमारा बहुत सारा लॉस हो जाता है. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स बिकॉज ऑफ डिले एड्रेसिंग द इश्यूज इन द बिजनेस राइट. इफ यू एड्रेस यूर इश्यूज इन अ डिलेड वे द इश्यूज विल क्रिएट द अनदर एडजेसेंट इश्यूज एंड दिस एडजेसेंट इश्यू विल क्रिएट अनदर एडजेसेंट इश्यू. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू नो दैट योर सिस्टम इज नॉट परफॉर्मिंग वेल एंड यू हैव नॉट कम्युनिकेटेड दिस टू द top management, what will happen? The sales will decrease, first thing the sales will decrease and you are not taking any decision to change, replace, train or improve the performance of sales managers. Then what will happen? Sales will decrease, this will result into stock of your inventory, this will result into blockage of finance, this will result into higher cost of production, this will result into stoppage or discontinuation of manufacturing process, right? So the one delay into decision making can result into multiple adjacent questions and problems for your business. Right, so this as suggested by the Chanakya, king has to listen those things on priority and he has to address those things. And delaying decisions will be like very risky for the king as well as for the business also. This is how the Indian mythology, Indian ethos, or Gautilas Arthashastra or the Niti, Chanakya Niti teaches you how to manage the businesses. And this is the significance of learning Indian ethos for better management practices in your corporate life. Right, so Chanakya also used to say that no one can defeat the powerful mind. Right. No one can defeat the powerful mind. So people can defeat you in terms of war, people can defeat you in terms of some other thing, but the people cannot defeat your mind. If your strategies are different, if your strategies are creative, innovative, and suitable to the issues you are facing in your life or your business, nobody can defeat the powerful mind. So what makes your mind powerful? Your mind is powerful only if you think that you have enough knowledge, your skill sets, right? Your attitude, your understanding defines the powerfulness of your knowledge, right? And there are a few things that Chanakya also has suggested to his king, and those things are all about economy, right? So the first legal and traditional. So the few things this suggested by Chanakya to Arya Chandragupta Maurya, he has come up with the legal. फ्रेंड टैक्सेशन सिस्टम राइट. चाणक्य ने टैक्सेशन सिस्टम का एक इनोवेशन किया था. ही हैज कम अप विद द फार्मूलाज टू डेवलप टू एस्टिमेट द टैक्सेशन, कितना टैक्स लेना चाहिए लोगों से, उसका उसने सजेस्ट किया था चंद्रगुप्त मौर्य को. चाणक्य जी ने सजेस्ट किया था. सो द टैक्सेशन सिस्टम इन इंडिया एंड इकोनॉमिक सिस्टम्स दैट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ द लेवल्स ऑफ टैक्स ही हैज टू फिक्स फॉर हिज पीपल हैज बीन सजेस्टेड बाय द चाणक्यस बुक और चाणक्यस अर्थशास्त्र. सो this is something which Chanakya has highlighted through his book called Chanakya's Arthashastra, that people have to consider, right? Any difficulty now? Chanakya has also highlighted what is the leadership, right? Chanakya has also highlighted what is the leadership, what are the characteristics of good leader, in terms of giving the strategy for Chandragupta Maurya and the leadership strategies that Chanakya was like developed, Chanakya was suggesting to the Chandragupta Maurya was similar, like the leadership is something which has been which should have a visionary attitude, right? So what visionary attitude this Chanakya had? Chanakya had the, you know, if you know the Chanakya's lifestyle, he has been set under a lot by the people in society. Chanakya ko bahut torture kiya gaya tha. Chanakya ji jab bachpan mein the, unka bachpan bahut problem mein guzra tha. He had so many issues in life. So what kind of vision he has developed? Why Chanakya is also considered as a good leader who has created, he is a kingmaker, right? So the leader should be a good kingmaker. He should always support people to become great. And he should have a visionary attitude. So Chanakya's own vision was to achieve Akhand Bharat. Chanakya's own vision was to complete, to have a control on the entire Asian region as Akhand Bharat. So he could not, he just could not do that. So what he did? He became a strategician only. He knew that he's a Brahmin. He had to, he had no knowledge of how to fight or what is the, what are the characteristics of a Kshatriya person who fights the war and who has all the resources in terms of people, money, or like the attitude to fight and everything, skills to fight. So what he did? He has gone to Chandragupta Maurya and he has fulfilled, or we can say that he has achieved his dream of establishing the Akhand Bharat, establishing the power on Akhand Bharat by Chandragupta Maurya. So वो खुद नहीं कर सकते थे, उन्होंने दूसरे से करवा के लिया, right? चाणक्य खुद नहीं कर सकते थे, but उन्होंने दूसरे से करवा के लिया. That is what something we call as the leadership character. If you should have an ability to motivate people, being a leader, you should have an ability to push the people to the highest performance, right? The leadership lesson given by the Chanakya is that you can push the people to the highest level. So this is something like Chanakya has talked about in his book called Chanakya Niti, right? And this Chanakya Niti was a great guidance, great guidance to the people and kings those days, right? So then the Chandragupta Maurya's dynasty has been followed by his like Siddhas and the king called Gautam and the king called Bindusara. These people here, the followers of Chanakya, followers of Maurya dynasty, right? So this is what we can talk about Chandragupta Maurya. Any question you want to ask me about this? No questions? Okay, let's put it then. And I will also let you know a few more points about this. Some of the principles mentioned in the book called Kautilya's Arthashastra are principles of management, the principle of education, principle of accounting system. These are the few things that Chanakya has suggested to Chandragupta Maurya to incorporate his dynasty, right? So you have to manage people, you have to manage education also, right? If you want to become a good king, give a good lifestyle to people, and you can give it to the people by having educational system of them. So he suggested, right? He suggested to give the good education to the people. So Chandragupta Maurya's principles were guided by Chanakya, and these are talking about corporate governance model of Chanakya, right? So he has suggested how to govern the entire kingdom, right? He has suggested how to govern, how to keep control over entire kingdom. Similarly, this governance model of Chanakya, which has been used by Chandragupta Maurya, could be highly applicable in the corporate world also, right? So Chanakya's strategies are still applicable into the corporate world, right? So the another lesson that Chanakya has given to Chandragupta Maurya was about the confidence, right? Confidence and the confidence of Chandragupta Maurya. He always quoted that once you start working on something, don't be afraid of failure and don't abandon it. People who work sincerely are the happiest people in the world, on the planet, right? So the kind of dedication is something that Chandragupta Maurya has been receiving, the importance of dedication that Chandragupta Maurya has been receiving from Chanakya, right? Chanakya was defining how dedicated the king should be. Right, if king decided that we are going to fight, then whatever is the situation, don't be afraid of whether we will win or lose. Jab war mein ja rahe hain tabhi hum harenge, soch ke jayenge to kuch hone wala nahi hai, darke jayenge to kuch hone wala nahi hai, right? So people who work sincerely are the most happiest. Whether you win or you lose is a different situation.
it's important whether you have worked sincerely or not. That is something you need to understand, right? So the time, another thing, this Chanakya has always highlighted in his philosophical discussions with Chandragupta Maurya was like, time perfects men as well as destroys them, right? Time perfects people as well as destroys them. So you have to wait for the right time to implement the right strategy, right? You have to wait for the right time and for right strategy when you talk, when you take a decision. So let the right time come, it will prove you, right? It will make you perfect about what is you are thinking and what you are interested to achieve in your life. And if you do the movement or if you take the moves wrong time, if the time it destroys you. So wait for the right opportunities and then hit, right? So that has been also discussed in the lessons from Mahabharata also. You are wait for the right time. And then you can play your moves, right? So wait for the right time and right opportunity in the market also. Being a manager, being a business owner, जब भी आपको लगता है उठ के कुछ भी नहीं करना चाहिए, right time का इंतजार करो and make the moves based on the strategies your competitors are using in the market. Another point is that I'm just highlighting Chanakya's Arthaniti, right? I cannot go in details about all the books, so I'm highlighting some famous books of Chanakya. Chanakya used to say that one who can't determine his goals cannot win. Right? समझ में आया? आपको पता ही नहीं हो रहा है गोल्स, तो हाउ यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट टू विन? और एक फेमस कोट है चाणक्य का. चाणक्य ऑलवेज यूज्ड टू से दैट योर एनिमीज, राइट, एंड द बैड थिंग्स ऑफ योर लाइफ, इन दोनों में दोनों से अगर बचना है तो आपको एक ही चीज करनी पड़ेगी. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेव यूर सेल्फ फ्रॉम योर एनिमीज, जैसे आप रस्ते से जा रहे हो, गाड़ी गाड़ी आती है, राइट, गाड़ी मतलब बैड बैरियर्स, राइट, अगर आपको एनिमी और बैरियर्स दोनों को जीतना है तो यू हैव टू डिस्ट्रॉय देम. एंड द थिंग इज लाइक अगर आप दुश्मन से और कांटों से दोनों से जीतना चाहते हो, इफ यू वांट टू बी फ्रॉम बोथ ऑफ देम यू हैव टू डिस्ट्रॉय देम, राइट. दिस आर टू लेसंस गिवन बाय द चाणक्य इन हिज चाणक्य नीति, राइट. समझ में आ रहा है? See, there is something called as the next point of your syllabus, which talks about the corporate Rishi model of the business, right? Corporate Rishi model of the business. You know how we have defined the Rishi Munis, right? How we have defined the Rishis and the Munis and Acharyas in Indian tradition. Kaise hum ko define kiya? What are the characteristics of Rishis, right? If you are a bit spiritual person, if you really know about the characteristics of Rishis. Rishis are like, Rishis are like selfless, right? Rishis are the people, those who are selfless. It means they are not someone who are very selfish, who are expecting things to happen for their own betterment only, right? के लिए कुछ नहीं चाहिए था उनको, right? If you follow the corporate Rishi model in your business, if you follow Rishi, if you behave like a Rishi when you are managing the thing, right? अगर आप manager life जीने के time पे Rishi जैसा जीते हो, Rishi Muni जैसा जीते हो, तो it will create a very different kind of impact, right? So what is the character of Rishi? Selflessness. If you behave the manager, behave like a Rishi in the position of manager, it means you are selfless for your own benefit. First thing, you give the importance to your company, right? So, and if you give the first importance to the benefits of company, you know that nobody can stop you growing, nobody can stop company growing. And if your company grows, right, if your company grows, By default, you and your team will get benefits, isn't it? So that's how it will be helpful for you to become a successful manager. Another characteristics of Rishis is that they used to spend too much time on meditation. They used to spend too much time on learning Vedas, right? So you as a manager should keep developing yourself by learning. You should have a habit of doing tapascharya, right? Practice, hard work, consistency, continuation, right? Dedication, determination, these are the characteristics of Rishis. So if you really want to become a good manager, you have to behave like Rishi. Rishi jitne selfless hote, utne aap selfless hona chahiye. You should not have any personal grudges with the people in your team. You should not have any personal aspirations from the company. Personal aspirations you can keep from your personal life, not from the company. Right? Company ne aapko positions deni chahiye, bahut bada karna chahiye, ye sab cheeze aap nahi kar sakte. Aap performance karo, that is your personal aspiration. If you perform, company will definitely take you to the upper level. So behave like Rishis. Rishis used to do tapascharyas for 10, 15, 20 years and years, you know that, right? So Rishi ke jaise tapasya hone chahiye, that gives you the the outcome of your hard work, right? So, and if you know that, what happens if someone messes up with the Rusis, like someone messes up with the Rusi, क्या होगा उसका? ऋषि के साथ कोई मेसअप कर लिया तो क्या होगा? ऋषि उसको क्या करते थे? कर्स देते थे, right? ऋषि used to curse that person, like शाप देते थे, फिर उसका पूरा कार्यक्रम हो जाता था, right? So you should be such पावरफुल पर्सन इन द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड. आप खुद भी उतने पावरफुल होने चाहिए कि अगर आपको लगा कि किसी ने आपके साथ कोई मिसबिहेव किया या फिर समथिंग वेंट रॉन्ग विथ यू इन योर कंपनी और इन योर स्ट्रेटजी और इन योर जॉब फंक्शन, देन द थिंग एंड द रिपरकशंस दैट पर्सन हु इज नॉट फॉलोइंग द इंस्ट्रक्शंस गिवन बाय मैनेजर और हु इज नॉट परफॉर्मिंग एज पर द एक्सपेक्टेशंस दैट मैनेजर हैज सेट अप, देन दैट पर्सन शुड गेट the curses kind of outcome from the managers. So managers उतने strict भी होने चाहिए, right? अगर आप strict ही नहीं हो तो आपका कोई सुनेगा ही नहीं, right? So आपको उतना strict होना चाहिए जितने ऋषि मुनि strict हुआ करते थे उनके life में, उनके behavior में. So the people will automatically respect you in that case and they will follow you and they will like fulfill required the things also, right? So being like Rishi, being like Rishi helps you to become most effective manager, right? And another characteristics of Rishi is like they were the people, those who had no partiality, no differentiation. पूरी दुनिया के कल्याण के लिए जीते थे, right? They used to live themselves for the betterment of entire mankind. So you as a manager should also behave and should also have the purpose of your life, the larger purpose of your life, which will help you to create an impact over entire society. You as a manager should not think only for the betterment of company or only for the betterment of you or your staff. Look after the purpose, look after the impact you are creating on the society. And by that way, you can improve and you can consider the purpose of your life to become a manager. See, company ka business chalana, paise kamana, ye ek purpose nahi hona chahiye. See, the larger purpose of your business is to provide values to your customers, right? Larger purpose of your business is not to earn money. Wo to short term hai. If you only run behind earning money, your business will get shut down very soon. सिर्फ पैसा कमाने के पीछे हमने बिजनेस किया तो कितना दिन चलेगा, राइट? इसको द पर्पस ऑफ द बिजनेस इज टू प्रोवाइड बेटरमेंट सॉल्यूशंस टू योर कस्टमर्स. वो होता है तो बिजनेस ज्यादा दिन चलेगा, राइट? सो द पर्पस ऑफ योर लाइफ शुड बी डिफाइंड एंड इट शुड बी अ लार्जर पर्पस. लाइक ऋषिज हैड द लार्जर पर्पस. वो भगवान की प्रार्थना करते थे. क्यों? खुद के लिए गाड़ी बंगला मांगते थे क्या? या फिर खुद के लिए कुछ उन्होंने मांगा है, मुझे इतना सोना दो, मुझे ये दो वो दो, राइट? दे हैव आस्क्ड the powers, they have asked the powers to the God. By utilizing those powers, they have been like working for the betterment of society. Powers mangi hai, intellectual cheeze mangi hai hamesha, right? Rishis Muni ne Bhagwan se hamesha intellectual cheeze mangi hai. So we also have to have an attitude. We should also have an attitude which helps us to become like Rishis, right? So that's the model of being corporate Rishi, and any difficulty till now? Something which you did not understood? Any difficulty? Okay, so thank you so much. I will stop here. If you have any query, you can ask. I'll give you a couple of minutes. We will discuss further if you really want to ask me something. So by discussing couple of points more, we will be closing up with your second unit. We need to discuss what do you mean by Veda model, and we need to discuss what do we mean by East-West theory, right? West-East theory, that is WE theory. So only two points we need to discuss in the coming session. We will talk about Veda model of leadership, and then we will talk about West-East theory and theory K. The three points are remaining from your second chapter, right? अगर आपको लगता है कुछ मिसिंग है सिलेबस में से तो यू कैन गेट बैक टू मी. आई विल डेफिनेटली ट्राई टू वर्क आउट ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. सो आई थिंक वी स्टिल हैव 20 मोर मिनट्स टू गो. आई विल टेक योर क्वेरीज. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन जस्ट कम बैक टू द डिस्कशन. Any question? Any question? Okay. So I was talking to you about the who is the host. Now I don't know. May I know who is the host? Can you just make me host? Deepthi, can you make me host? I lost my connection due to this internet issues. Hello, Deepthi, are you there? Hello. Deepthi, can you hear me? Guys, you can just leave the meeting. Deepthi is not responding, maybe. So we stop the session here. We'll get back to you in the coming session. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for your response and patient listening. All the best to you all.